Question here from Kelly. Does Asana have the capability to store Excel and Word documents? And can you edit and save documents within the system in real time without having to download and re-import? Now, Asana itself doesn't allow you to have a document editor within the actual application, but Asana does allow you to link to documents pretty easily. And that's what we typically find ourselves doing. So what does that look like? Well, I'm going to go ahead and jump into my Asana here. You can see here that I actually have task open for my Q&A that I'm working on today. And inside there, I've got everything I need for my Q&A, including things like the description that I've got uploaded. But I also have a link to my presentation, which shows me all of my presentation slides, which are just one click away. There we go. And there is your question. So you also have the ability to actually use an attachment feature and attach files. I can attach a file from Google Drive, and that's going to open up in a separate window. I don't really use this feature because it's much easier just to drop in the URL. But if you really wanted to attach a file, there is a way that you could do that. Let me go ahead and open up my files from this morning. I'll go ahead and hit the select button. And I think the only real difference here is that it adds a little visual element of the attachment there. So it might make it a little bit easier for people to see and for people to find. Now, if you want to, you can add other files into a task, like for example, a file from my computer. And we do those from time to time. If we need to add something like a screenshot, you know, maybe it's a title for a video with something like, you know, what we would use as a thumbnail for YouTube, that's going to automatically show up there. Maybe let's see if I can find a better example, actually. So here's my thumbnail for my Q&A. So here's where you may use attachments inside Asana to help you as visual aids. I'm going to go ahead. Here we go. Wonderful. So you'll see here that I've actually got what's set up as a Kanban board where I've got different content ideas, you know, right from raw ideas to ideas being developed. They'll go through a review process and then they go into our stream queue when they're ready to be streamed. But I can actually move these back and forward, and I can even have in Asana different rules trigger, different automations trigger. For example, when I move something into the record stream column, it automatically assigns it to myself, which is a nice little feature there. But attaching an image to a card inside Asana gives you that visual representation of what the piece of content. So if you're someone who's highly visual like me, it makes it nice and easy to move it between the different areas inside here. So that's something that is useful for me, maybe useful for you as well. But apart from that, I probably wouldn't recommend using Asana as your primary file storage for what you're doing inside your business. Remember that anytime you're working with an app like Asana, effectively, you're wedding yourself to that app anytime that you are putting data up inside that app. You know, if it's something that's a bit ephemeral and transient, like, you know, preparing for a presentation, once a presentation's over, you know, you don't really need to access any of those files anymore, that's fine. But I probably wouldn't use Asana for something like a job folder for a customer where you're going to be working with that customer over a number of years. Let's say maybe you're an accounting firm and you want to have one folder with all the stuff for your customer. That's the kind of thing I would instead recommend that you use Google Drive for. And I'd strongly recommend you consider using shared drives. Shared drives have a number of really cool features where you can set up particular drives. For example, where you can actually choose who can contribute to the folder, who can remove files from the folder, who can add files from the folder, and you can really get some great settings set up there. So for example, if I go ahead and open up in my folder here, let's say, for example, I go to my training folder and just see who has access to different levels in the training folder. You can see that those who are a member of the executive group have manager access. Those who are pod leaders, so that's our management team, have contributor access so they can add files but not delete them. The empower team, which is our HR team, can actually manage and move around and clean up and delete the files. And then we have our dev team. They must have some automation set up there, but everyone in the company is a viewer and they are able to view everything. So thanks very much for the question. The second part of your question is, you know, can you use these systems to work in real time without having to download and re-import them? Well, anytime you make a change inside your Asana, it's automatically going to update. So the description field here is basically automatically updating, and it updates pretty quickly, pretty much instantly when you've got other people working in there. But it's not the kind of place where I would compose a full proposal for a customer, for example, if there's other people working on the task, because the error handling is not fantastic. And sometimes two people are working at the same time and they can overwrite what each other's doing. And there's no undo button for that description field in Asana. And there is not also the ability to go back and look through different versions of what that description was easily and kind of reconcile who changed what. And so I would recommend as much as possible to use the Google document formats, because they are actually going to give you a better experience with working collaboratively in documents. And then what we end up doing, as I've shown you, is to just link into the actual description with the file URL. And that way everyone's got access to the correct file. Nice and simple. If you like this content, please hit subscribe and hit the bell notification so you can be notified when we go live or drop new content on the channel. Now, if you'd like to connect with us, hit us up on social media or join our free community group. All the links to that are right below this video. If you'd like to learn more about Google Workspace and the technology ecosystem, you can join our free Genius Academy by transferring your billing across to itGenius, or you can join a Workspace Basics Bootcamp. Now, if you're a business owner and you're interested in an audit on your technology stack or your Workspace account, or you're looking to do a project in the tech world, well, you can take advantage of our free consultation. And if you need help right now, then consider joining Concierge or taking up a quick fix with our team for professional support for your tech stack.